Hey guys, Mike here. Welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to be going over some of the new features of engine owning. As you guys know, we did a full review of their product about 6 months ago, maybe back in January, February timeframe. And we're going to revisit because the recent events of this week have sort of prompted that. They've moved servers. They've got a new data center. They've updated their domain name and so forth. So let's sort of get right into it. Before we get started, this content provided here is for the educational, research, and documentary purposes only. We, of course, do not recommend that anyone perform the tasks we show in this video or use these tools. Now, with that out of the way, a couple things. Let's get some of the general housekeeping out of the way. So, as you can see, we're running Windows 10. This is the 1904. This is 21H1. And we are currently on Viper 1. This is one of our gaming rigs dedicated to this purpose. We're going to bring over the new engine owning website. As you can see, looks and feels sort of the same. We've gone ahead and logged into our account. I got to tell you, we're not a big fan of the new update for CAPTCHA. But nonetheless, if you don't have an account here, you can always make one. They are free. You'll notice that the domain name has been changed from engineowning.com to engineowning.to, but it doesn't matter. If you try to go to engineowning.com, it'll automatically redirect you here. You'll see that, of course, they do declare the new domain name. If you're having problems with the loader, download the new loader. As you can see down further, they do offer still a variety of products that you could choose from, cheats for just about all of the popular titles. Going back to, you know, Battlefield 1 and all the way up to the current Warzone stuff. We've gone ahead and made the purchase ahead of this video for the Call of Duty Warzone stuff. We just got ourselves a quick 3-day pass so that we could explore the new features, document them for you, and talk through them. We will say that by purchasing the product, we did notice that there are a substantial amount of options now. So for those that aren't comfortable using a credit or debit card online, and of course I am one of those, you can now not just get stuck having to use cryptocurrencies. We see a lot of comments in the chat about folks that just aren't comfortable with either one of those methods. They don't have a credit card and they also don't have crypto, or you know, they're just frustrated that crypto is the only method. Well, there is some reprieve. Now we've got Apple Pay, Google Pay, Alipay. We've got a whole bunch of different options here. Made the purchase experience, frankly, quite simple. I cannot remember for the life of me if this click here to purchase for another user has always been here. But you guys can let me know in the comments. I almost want to say it was, but I'm not quite sure that it... I see so many of these cheat tools in a month, man. I just can't remember if this was actually here. Maybe I should go back to my old video and take a look for myself. Anyway, so from here, one of the things we do need to make sure we take care of, because it is a Friday, so we do know that there are some updates occasionally as we reach the weekend. And currently, the engine owning Call of Duty Modern Warfare Warzone is undetected, as is everything else. And all of their servers around the world are currently online and available, which is fantastic. All right, now to get to the new loader. So we went ahead and clicked here. We're super thankful that they made this process of actually finding the loader to download really easy. This is what the new loader it looks like. Visually, it's going to be the same, but the underlying code and foundation, of course, has been updated. We're going to go ahead and showcase some of that. So down here, clicking on this download to client keygen, and of course we went ahead and clicked download there. Now, a couple of things to note over here in our security settings in Windows. I clicked on update and security and Windows security here. Notice, take note that all of my protections are fully engaged. Everything's on. If you're working with a cheat manufacturer that has a requirement that you turn all of this off, you might want to reconsider how you're doing things, whether or not that's a good option for you. I always recommend that if you're going to engage in this sort of activity for testing or educational purposes or research, that you use a rig that is committed 100% to just that function. In other words, don't mix your gaming life with your personal life, right? Keep those two things on separate machines in your lab. That's why I have several. Understanding that it is a bit of an investment, but you never know what you're going to get. I mean, to be safe is best, right? So in this case, the virus protection only needs a little bit of help. And what I mean by that is, under the virus protection settings, we manage the settings here. Notice everything else is on, yeah? The only option that we've chosen to modify is under the exclusion section, we've added an exclusion for our build folder. What this means is that anything that runs from that folder will not be scanned or checked by the Microsoft Windows antiviral system. So when I run stuff out of that folder, it's free to run. I'm the administrator. I know what I'm doing. This is a dedicated device. You know, what's the worst that could happen? I somehow managed to pooch up the works and I have to reinstall Windows. I don't have anything of value on this machine. I could care less. I do not recommend adding the downloads folder as a part of that exclusion. Do not add your downloads folder like this here. Do not do that, okay? That is absolutely a horrible idea. Because take it from a guy that's been in the IT security space for almost 30 years, you don't want to do that part. It does mean, however, that when you download this file, that you will see that you do get prompted, right? So if I click on download, let's find one that's working. That's why they have more than one. Okay, apparently none of them are working. There we go. All right, so a quick refresh. You'll notice that I get this message down here that says it's not commonly downloaded, might be dangerous. And the option it presents me with is to discard. The reason it's giving me this message is because the content inside of the zip file is an executable that is not digitally signed by the development outfit, by the coders. In order to digitally sign this executable, it would require the developers to work with a certificate authority like VeriSign or others in order to get an SSL certificate, and that would expose their identity. In this particular case, developers of these sorts of tools simply can't do that. It's just not something that Microsoft or would ever approve. So you do get this warning. This is okay, though. You have an option here. You can keep it, right? So all you have to do is just click on the button, click keep, and it'll download the file for you. And then once it's done, we can show it in folder, and we can bring that folder over here. Now that we have the zip file here, we just simply cut it. And we're going to go ahead and place it into our build folder. And we're going to go to engineoding. We're going to get rid of the old one. We're going to go ahead and paste the new one. And then we're just simply going to extract those files right here. And of course, we get the same two files that we've always gotten. We get the executable and we get the identically named INI file. The INI file contains your license key and other encryption data. Not a big deal. But you'll notice that the folder and the files, they're all having the same file name. Don't ever rename these. Don't think you're going to be cool and rename them and stuff, because they may not work properly after that. Once we have the executable downloaded, I will jump into the background here and just close up a couple of things in sites and stuff, close up the command prompt, close up our build folder, and we will go ahead and right-click and run as administrator. You'll notice the blue window. Again, this is Microsoft's Windows 10 antiviral system warning us, especially with Defender Smart Screen, that this PC is an unrecognized application. And this is, again, generated because it doesn't have a valid digital signature. That's okay. We're expecting these messages because we know where the content comes from. So click on More Info and just click on Run Anyway. Once that begins to run, I'm going to close out that window and we'll let this thing go ahead and run for us. The loader will come up. I will empty my recycle bin over there. the loader comes up and, of course, logs in as me. That's part of the transparency that Engine Owning provides, is that you can't download the executable without logging into the website as yourself. So it automatically knows who I am. Every single time that you download this tool, it's embedded with your stuff. That's what's in the INI file. If you try to share this or move it between computers, that's never going to work. All right, so Engine Owning. So we're going to click on the Call of Duty Modern Warfare and Warzone. You will see that this status is currently undetected. This expires on the 11th day of this month in 2021. Remember, these are European, so the day and month are backwards. This is not November 7th, right? That's this month, that's 7, right? So that is this month right here. It's going to expire on Sunday, which is July 11th, okay? So edit, unlock, all in the miscellaneous, and that's what we're here to try out. It's a brand new feature. Just got released on Monday, which is when they were moving their servers and systems. Lots of folks are asking for us to showcase that. We're going to do exactly that. So we're going to go ahead and load. And the traditional common menu, common item we get here, press OK to launch the game afterwards. So what has this done so far? This has loaded the software, downloaded any updates. It's injected itself into high memory. And we're going to go ahead and launch Battle.net. We are going to log in with a brand new user account. If you guys are following my channel, you'll see that I literally just created this account moments ago. So we're going to log in with the exact same account. We just got done running through training and dropping into our first match and all of that good stuff. Fighting a cold this week, so beg your pardon if I sound nasally and overly congested. All right, so anytime that we see that kind of an update, my best practice is to go ahead and close the game, reload my cheat, right? That's normal for me. So I'll go right back here into the build folder and right back into Engine Owning, get right back into my executable. You'll notice that on the second time I launch this, that it doesn't prompt me again with that blue screen. I've already submitted to Windows that this is a acceptable executable. I know who it is and what it's about. So same thing, undetected, blah, blah. Let's load it up. Kind of nice that we got a chance to go through that second time, because that gives us the ability to show you that you don't get that prompt the second time through. And we're going to launch our Battle.net here. Go ahead and log in with this freshie. That is my password, I promise. There we go. A little bit too quick with the fingers. All right, so we're going to add no more updates. Always make sure to check your region, especially if you're using accounts that you've acquired somewhere else. And we're going to go ahead and hit play. And we're just going to slide this over to another screen and let the splash screen come up right here. All right, right about now, we're going to fire up our controller. We're going to go ahead and pick up and launch our RE-WSAD, or I always say that wrong, RE-WASD. All right, so for those that are not familiar with this tool, this just simply is a tool you can download. If you go to Google and just look up RE-WASD, this allows you to remap keys and pedals and steering wheels and controllers, mouse buttons, whatever you want. And on the back side, I have an Elite controller, an Elite 2 controller. And on the back side of it, I've got some of the flippy pedals installed. I have this one installed. This one is currently not installed, but they're just magnetic, so it's fine. You just simply click on the key and you just drop down the menu of what you want that key to do now. And in this case, I have it as labeled as the X1 mouse button, which is the side mouse button that would normally be on a gaming controller. Don't do turbo, don't do toggle, don't do any of that other stuff. And once you've got that configured and set, just click on apply. It's really very simple. I've gone ahead and I've added this wallpaper in the background just by using the function called box art. So that's it. Remap is on, the controller is set, everybody's happy. We'll move that out of the way. Over here, the reason that's important is because when I use an aim key, which I'm particularly a big fan of, I just click on set, and then I just click the flappy paddle, and it declares mouse 4. We're all good to go. So let's explain what we've got here. We're going to be using the aimbot. We're going to be doing on zoom. We're going to be doing smooth aim and acceleration at 0. These values are sometimes different from one cheat manufacturer to another. For engine owning, 0 is the fastest. So if you want to instantly snap to the head, this is the configuration for that. Head first and scan, or just head only, right? If you move this up, then it will be a little bit slower to snap around. So moving it up to 100 is going to be, you know, and chest first scan. That setting right there will be the most legit it could ever possibly look. Still detectable if you have a trained eye, but for the most part, layman's just never going to really be able to tell too much. We've been asked to do a video on that type of behavior, and we will. So we're going to bring these all the way down because we're raging with this account. We don't care. We just want to get and show you the features. Silent aim, we're going to leave that off. Silent aim is bonkers crazy. We're going to leave that off. We want to be able to see the target. And because we're going to be using things like no recoil and no spread, because we have those on, we want to be able to showcase that. In order to do that, we have to leave silent aim off. You need to be able to see where the reticle is and where the bullets are. Okay, so everything else is in order. Mouse 4, we're going to be doing a third of the screen as our field of view, and we're going to be aiming priority field of view and distance. We're going to be aiming at downed players. You betcha. We're going to drive those people into the ground. We're going to draw the aim box. We're going to use visibility check. Very important. Visibility check means that we will not automatically target enemy players that are in cover. It means we're only going to be targeting enemy players when they emerge from cover and are fully visible to me. We are not going to aim at friendlies. We are only going to aim at enemies. Aiming at friendlies is never fun. We are not going to be using the trigger bot at all. We will cover this in another video. We are going to use ESP. So that's on, 3D brackets, my particular choice. Player skeleton, of course, that's on. Your options here are 2D brackets, 2D off. Filled brackets, which kind of gets annoying, because it's a big, you know, giant red or yellow blob. I like the 3D brackets because I like to use skeleton. I like to see the other player's physical position, like if they're prone or crouched, what direction they might be facing. That stuff becomes more obvious as we get into game. I do want to see the player name because I do keep track a little bit mentally about who I'm taking out and where other hackers in the lobby might be. Also, player distance, because I do like to make sure that I know exactly how far that target is and whether I need to be worried about it. I want to know what kind of weapon they have that helps me approach the player. If they've got a shotgun and they're around a corner in cover, I'm not just going to spin that corner with a handgun. I don't need to see the line, though. I know how to get there. I don't care about grenades or distances or anything like that. I do want to see some loot. So I do have item names and distances turned on, but you can see down at the bottom, the item range is really low. It's at 100, and I may even go lower than that. I may go down to, you know, like into the 80s. Because when you turn this up, man, I'm telling you, the screen gets really, really busy. It's just a blur of color and noise. And the default font size is 2.0. I've reduced that to 1.5, and you'll see how that's relevant in a minute. It helps to reduce some of the visual noise, in my opinion. For the radar, this radar over here, I'm definitely not going to be using that at all. We don't need to see anything else, really. I'm not going to be using radar. We are going to be showcasing the Unlock All tool. So as you guys know, this is a freshie account. It's level 1, and we're going to jump right in, and we're going to go right into you know, we're going to have, everything is going to be wide open. We got no recoil, no spread, rapid fire on for things like pistols and handguns and stuff. I am particularly fond of the crosshair. I'm not going to lie. I like the crosshair, and we're going to keep the crosshair size at around 20, and we're going to use the cross. We don't do the diagonal too. It doesn't, I don't like it. Colors we're leaving as all natural. We're going to save that in startup settings, save in slot one, save for our startup settings, and we're going to go ahead and hit insert and put that away. All right, let's get into the game. Now, remember, these many of these menus are click-through menus, right? So when you hit insert and bring the menu up, just remember that depending on the type of cheat, you can actually click through it. With the engine owning product, that's not the case, but with a lot of other products, it is. I usually recommend hitting pause on your controller before bringing up your menu, because that seems to be a pretty universal thing that you could use with any of the cheat manufacturers, and not have to click through so much. So we're going to go ahead and tuck that away for a minute. You can see the red crosshair is a visual confirmation that hacks are loaded and working, that the cheats are there. So we're going to go immediately into weapons. As you can see, we've not really even been in this menu yet. We'll go to operators. We've not even been in this menu yet either. I'm still clicking all the continue. You can see all the operators are open. So we can pick any operator we want. Let's take this one, for example. And everything's unlocked. All of it's there. I like that one. That's pretty cool. Oh, and it's not as scheduled to come out until season 6. Nice. So you guys can scroll through. I mean, there's 1,000 things to look at in here, right? Every single one of them has, you know, all of the features and all of the skins and customizations open. You guys have to, you know, spend some time in here and, you know, go through all of this stuff. You can see now the color on the left-hand side right here, this light blue, that just means rare. And as you go further down in the list, you'll see that that color changes. So it becomes epic. And then if you get down to something that's orange, those are legendary ones. But you can see they're all open. Everything's here. You know, pick and choose the character that you want to play with. You know. America. There we go. The Weekend Warrior. Anyway, you get, you know, every available option. Okay. So there we have it. So we're going to play with this one. We're going to play with Mace. We like the skin. I really like the kind of the tattoos kind of look like they're almost look like those are branding, like he was branded. Like he had his arm stuck in a machine and it burned into him and branded him. It's pretty cool. All right, we're going to use that one. Okay, so that's our operator. And let's go through and just kind of look. Every operator is open all the way over here to Wyatt. And Wyatt's got some cool ones too, because I've seen his before. There it is, the Roadhog, all red. Pretty legend. It's pretty cool. I like it. Cesspool. There we go. The Fixer kind of looks like me. The Woodsman. Yeah, you could spend all day in here, you know. Here we go. Legendary season. You'll see this a lot. This is legendary from season 6. When you see guys out there running with this skin, they've either purchased it or they've unlocked it. Here she is. Here's Mara. Mara, whatever, however you guys want to say it. Yeah. Okay. So that covers that. So we're going to be using Jackal. Let's head into the weapons. We want to create. We want to create a loadout. Don't care about the battle pass. No one cares about the battle pass. No one cares about challenges. No one cares about barracks right now. We're going to come back to that in a second. All right, let's create ourselves a loadout. Now, because I'm level one, I'm not even supposed to be able to create a loadout yet, as you guys know, but we're going to create one anyway. First thing we're going to do is take a look at what's in the store. Let's take a look. This is just a kilo. Let's change that to, let's see, what should we use? What's a good one? Let's do the Farah. Now, if I go back to the Farah here, if I go into the armory, okay, this is where all the blueprints would be. And here's all the blueprints, man. They're all unlocked. All the blueprints are present and accounted for. Yeah. Blueprints are the only way that you can, that they're the only way that I know of to get things like Shattered Blast, all the special effects that happen when you shoot at the enemy. I don't know of any way to do that without getting a blueprint. But let's take a look at some other weapons. Here's the Gorza. Now, remember, the ones with the arrows, that's where the skin is dynamic. It'll change. So this one called Motherboard, it'll it's alive. It'll be adaptive. And, yeah, they're all, everything's unlocked, right? So you guys will have to go through and sort of pick what you want. If you, and that includes all the weapons. Here's all the SMGs, right? They're all open. You know, Bullfrog, we'll make a class with that. The AUG, here's the Bison. The MP5's wide open. 26 different kinds of this. I mean, everything's unlocked, right? So it definitely works. All the shotguns are open. All the LMGs are unlocked. Some of them have more, you know, more than others when it comes to the blueprints, but you know, whatever. Here's all the tactical rifles and all the marksman rifles that you could ever want. There's the Kar 98. Yeah, big popular one. And there's 23 of those. Yeah. Some crazy stuff. And of course, sniper rifles. My favorite, the Pellington. Don't judge me. You'll see why in a minute. Pellington, I love the Pellington. And I love the Swiss. The Tundra's a little bit too slow for me. This is a little bit too slow. These big, you know, these big 50 cals are just too slow. I'd rather be a little bit closer and use something a little bit lighter. Okay, so let's make a loadout. So the Farah 83, let's go into the gunsmith. First thing I typically do is go straight into ammunition, right? So I'm going to just slap on the VDV 60 round fast mag. I'm going to go ahead and choose my optic, and I'm going to do a 3x optic. Then I want to get some speed, so I'm going to do a rear grip. Aim down sight time, flinch resistance. Let's do that. Grab that stock. This is ADS firing move speed. No. That's not fast enough for me. Let's do a barrel. We'll get that Spetsnaz barrel on there. See about a muzzle. The GRU suppressor, that'll be cool. And that's everybody. Okay, so let's go ahead over to customize. Let's do our camouflage. Look at this. Now, the psychedelics and things are not unlocked yet, but the mystery ones are, and or the mastery ones are, sorry, and I'll put DM Ultra. I can also do a special one, all these special ones. Let's get into reticles, and there's a lot of reticles to go through. I typically just like this one. And we'll throw a charm on there. We'll do the 1980s IBM clone PC. I typically don't do stickers, but I want to show you that all of the stickers are open. They're all unlocked. Right? Everything is, you know, wide open. Pick a sticker of your choice. Silver one looks okay. Looks pretty sexy to me. All right, we're going to pick a secondary weapon. So take a look at the 1911. It's the same story, right? So we have all of the blueprints that you could ever want. Yeah. And they're, of course, all open. You're going to explore that on your own time. I'm going to go ahead and use the gunsmith. Let's drop that. Oh, you know what? I actually want to use... Let's go with the X16. Let's do the basic. Let's do the 26 rounds. Trigger action. Do the match grade. Oh, and of course, I don't know if you noticed, but here next to the match grade trigger, like the other stuff, there's different types of little details you can put into your configuration, right? So these are, you know, this is all lightweight trigger stuff, but there's like specialty lightweight triggers. They don't change or enhance the lightweight trigger in any way, but if you're trying to do something more of a color scheme, you want to be consistent. So here for the match grade trigger, you can see that we've got blue, carbon, and whatever this Draugr is. We'll do that one because it's got that cool red clip on it. We're going to do the Syngard Advantage. We don't need any of that. Just going to keep it plain. Doesn't really matter to me to keep it plain because I'm going to put a skin on it anyway. And then rear grip. We want this thing to come up quick. So we're going to do the striped grip tape. Could do the stock. Nah, no rubberized. We want that aim down sight speed. And let's take a look at a laser, see if any of these help the aim down sight speed. There we go. So that will be the fastest pistol you'll find on the map. Let's go into camouflage. You can see that all of these are open, right? I know with the other weapon, it didn't seem like it, but here's all the skulls. We're going to go to completionist. Whew, that looks wicked. Look at that. Obsidian. Ooh, that sounded kind of Halo-ish, didn't it? We'll do the obsidian. For our perks, let's see. All the perks are open. So we're going to do double time and high alert and tune up. I like to know when people are shooting at me from the back. All of our lethals have been unlocked. So we're going to do the Molotov cocktail and the stunner. You can do whatever else you want. Stim, decoy, gas, heartbeat sensor. You know, pick whatever you want. I like the stun. All right, there's our loadout. Let's rename it and just call it primary loadout. All right. Now we're going to go ahead and make ourselves a quick sniper class, and then we'll get into the game and we'll start looking at stuff. There's our Pellington. We're going to switch to ammunition, do the salvo 9 rounds. We want some speed. There we go. Check that stock. That's sprint to fire time, but it's not fast enough. Let's check the barrel here. Fire rate and bullet velocity. I know it doesn't sound like that's going to do a lot, but we'll take that Tiger Team on there. And I always wondered why anybody would ever want to put a laser on a sniper rifle. But for the improvement in the aim down sight time, that might be worth it. But let's put a muzzle on there first. Here comes that wrapped suppressor. All right, here we go. This is it. The sound moderator helps to increase that aim down sight speed. And let's take a look and see if there's a stock that can help us with some of that. The sprint to fire time will be helpful. So we'll do this. Now you'll notice that there was an extra, right? I could do, you know, I got different options there. Not too concerned about it because we're just going to customize it anyway. Now in this one, because we left the default scope on, we don't get to customize the reticle, but that's okay. We don't care. We're going to head over to Mastery, and we're going to do this in DM Ultra. We're going to go ahead and put a charm on there, and you know that's going to be the 80s IBM clone PC. We'll do a sticker in slot one. We'll do the silver. And there we have it. Actually, that sticker may have looked better in slot two. There we go. All right. Now, same thing down here. We don't need to do specialist mode. I don't even know why they prompt you here, because it has no effect when you are in Warzone. Double time, high alert, tune up. Okay. I mean, it tells you right there. Modern Warfare Specialist has no effect in Warzone game modes. So why would they even prompt you here? I don't even know. Some people, myself included, got really excited when it went to activate Specialist. I guess that would only be helpful if you were in multiplayer or something. All right, frag and a flash. And we're just going to call this, we'll just rename this as our sniper. There's a lot more to cover. So we'll just call that our sniper loadout. All right, set and done. Let's go into vehicle customizations. We've got to have some fun in here. It's the ATV. And as you guys can see, we can do whatever we want. So we're going to grab one that has the red tracer effects. Why not? Now, the interesting thing is that even while I'm in here, I can customize my horns and my war tracks. So I can customize anything I want. The one that I've been using lately is this fire truck, but I think I'm going to do Flight of the Bumblebee. Ooh, with Hellscream. Retro. Ride of the Valkyries. That's it. That's our boy. All right. And War Tracks. So we can, we're going to do, let's see, Twisted Sister. Yeah. There we go. 80s rock. All right. Let's move on to the SUV. We're going to do sort of the same thing. We're looking for, you know, anything that's got trails. There we go. Flaming trail effect. And the horn. We'll do the Flight of the Valkyries. Where is it? There we go. Ride of the Valkyries. And we're going to go into War Tracks, and we'll do the we'll do 80s hip hop on that one. Let's get the Rover. Rover's got a very similar one to our other boy. Get down here and do the same thing. Forgot my war track. We'll do 80s hits too. And the cargo truck. All right, I'm particular about the cargo truck. America. And with the cargo truck, even though we've got that skin on, we want to do, I like doing the fire truck horn. Yeah, I want people to know I'm coming. And we'll do 80s hits. All right, one of my personal favorites in the chopper. You can pick whatever your heart desires, but I am particular with the Rainbow Runner. You betcha. And we're going to do Ride of the Valkyries, and let's do let's do 80 sets. And the dirt bike. We will get all the way over here to, yes, to the 80s. Four tracks. There we go. All right, now let's get some watches. They're all here. Every single watch. I'll go backwards because these are the legendary ones. So I want to get something from season four that's legendary. Ooh, season five. Let's see. That's crazy. Shake for answer. Well, that's not helpful. The Soul Searcher. Oh, it's like a piano. Oh, this one will track my KD. Where is it? Heck yes. Oh, that's even better. Yeah, we like that. Would be so cool if the little radar that you get with the cheat actually showed up in there. All right, that's our watch. These are all of the blueprints, weapons, and mods. Everything wide open. All of the operators wide open. Let's get over here to the barracks, clan tags, and regiments. Now, y'all know, if you see my clan tag, when you know, you know. Calling cards. All right, once we get past the top head of, like, flags and stuff, then they turn into the legendary calling cards. So there you go. Season four legendary calling cards all over the place. Death Blossom. Yep. Pick whatever you like. We'll do this one here. America. And as far as the emblems go, same thing with the emblems, man. They're all wide open. You see guys that have some of these emblems, like I said, they've either bought it or they've opened it up. So we'll do Starry-Eyed because America. The gestures and sprays. You want to know why you're seeing so much of that? Well, here's why. All the legendary ones are open right here. And we will set some of these up. Okay, there we go. And of course, any sprays that you might want. The ones that are purple and blocked out are ones that aren't available yet. So you'll see that these are all titled as season six. They haven't been finished making the artwork yet, so they haven't downloaded to my computer. So you'll see a bunch of ones that are kind of like that. All right, records and achievements, I have nothing. Zero and zero. All right, we are ready. Okie doke, so first order of business, we are going to get into a no-fill in plunder. I want to be able to run around for a minute without too much going on, and I want to be able to showcase the no spread and no recoil stuff, right? So we want to be able to showcase some of the miscellaneous options from here. We've just got done with the unlock all. We want to do the no recoil, no spread. I want to showcase that. I also want to show you rapid fire, those sorts of things, because that's all fairly new. And if you can believe it, right? We are literally level one, never played a game. We have unlocked everything, assigned it to our character, and Activision has no clue. No clue. I really don't know yet, because this has only been released for the handful of days, so it's hard to tell if this is the kind of activity that gets you banned faster. We're just going to have to wait and see how that plays out over the coming weeks. But look, if they're not checking for it now, I can't imagine they would be checking for it later. It'd be ridiculous. So we're going to drop into a quick plunder and just work on getting out of the way so we can show off some of the no recoil, no spread stuff. And there's our primary loadout. Perfect. And I forgot to... That is totally my bad, guys. I forgot to go in and set it up for controller. Sorry.
That's fine. I excited about all stuff. So, same as this. Actually, turns on because the algorithm sees that. Definitely. Contextual by all. That's their graphics. Turn that off to the sound. Yes, like that. You care about the penny. Yes, currently have. So, we're going to have funny. That.
And I think we're good. All right, let's do it again. This will be the third time that I load into a match and back out, right? So I loaded into a match and backed off in the previous video that I just made. Now I've loaded into another one and backed out immediately. Now I'm loading into a third one and backing out immediately. Let's make sure our in-game audio is turned off. It's hard to say. Activision's terms of service say that they record everything, including the audio now. It's hard to say if turning the in-game mic off prevents them from recording, or if you just shutting your mouth is the only way you can do that. It's kind of hard to know. I do find, however, that when I have my in-game mic on, that I'm usually raging and I get banned a lot quicker. Mostly talking about it. All right, sorry, and I'll just see these. Oh yeah, go on. Oh yeah, Jesus. Okay, now that that's over. Just being sloppy and ridiculous, like I think I got 9. All right, we'll see if we can get out here towards prison. I want to get somewhere where I've got a wall that I can use to shoot against that's not going to be really busy. I mean, I could take them out right now if I wanted to. Which I probably should, because they're... Oh, it looks like they're going to port, so... Is there a chopper down there? All right, there's no chopper down there. Oh, yeah, there is. Where was it? I did not see it. All right, whatever. We're going to go over here and grab this chopper. Let me get there. And, then we will start examining the benefits of this no recoil stuff. All right, we got the bird. Let's land. Okay, no recoil. So let's draw something. Put a mark right here. Wait, do I have bullet and sprays on? Got to be able to see texture. Hi. Yeah, bullet. Yeah, they're enabled. Okay, maybe that's not going to work. Let me go to a door. Yeah, okay, it's showing up. All right, so we're going to mark this spot right there, okay? And let's step back and take a look. I know there's a guy coming. Okay, back to our impacts. All right, so we're going to back up all the way. All right, ready? Not coming for me. So that's basically what you get when you're using the no recoil, no spread. So let's turn those off and let's save that and see the difference. See if there is a difference. We're going to go to the same spot on the wall, but we're just going to scoot over. That was a full clip. No handling from me. But you can see that trail up, right? All right, now what we're going to do is just put on the no recoil and see what that does. And then we'll do the no spread and see what that does. I might have enough ammunition for that. Enemy precision airstrike, take cover. Oh, Jesus. Really, dude? You're going to make me have to come up there? I'll pop the recon only because, and by the way, this is the fastest gun ever. Fast as fuck, boy. Bye. All right. Anyway, back to what we were talking about. So there's our no recoil, no spread. Here's our with recoil and spread turned off. And we need one more sample. So right now, what do we have? We have just no recoil turned on. So we're just going to check that one. So the no recoil is pretty comparable to the no spread, but you can see the density difference. This was two full clips or one full clip. This is also a full clip, but look at the amount of damage that was done. Look at the difference. That's quite significant. So now we're going to turn on the no spread again. So everything back to the on position. We've got 21 bullets left, but that'll be enough to give a sample. So we'll go right there and fire. And I'm telling you, everything is, it's so densely packed. Wait. All right, let's try it with a little gun. These SMGs are sometimes more wild. So let's go here. Same thing. Now, our current settings are no recoil, no spread, okay? So that's what we've got turned on. Oh, my God. Would you look at that? That is pretty amazing, especially at that distance. All right, let's turn that stuff off. And we will see the difference. I think we fired here. All right, we're going to scoot over just one block. Okay, that's what we did with no recoil, no spread. Here's with recoil and spread. And that's crazy. You'd have to start shooting at their feet. We'll do the same thing. We'll just turn the recoil part on, save that, and let's just scoot over. Let's see, we did this one. We did this one. Let's scoot here. All right, that's a full clip. Now, here's the difference. Here's what I'm showing y'all about. This is no recoil, no spread. This is with recoil and spread allowed. And the one next to us here is just simply no recoil. Yeah, just no recoil. You can see the impact difference between the two. No recoil, no spread, and just no recoil. Right? All right, let's do a fourth one. Let's see, we did one, two, three. We'll go right here. Right about here. Somebody got to a million already? Jesus. Oh, yeah. The density is so much better. Yeah. You can see the amount of damage this will do compared to the width to this. And certainly compared to the original. So, yeah, that's crazy. All right, guys. Well, that's going to wrap it up for this video. We'll see you in the next one. All right. I'm going to land right here on top. I'm going to land. Yo, listen. I'm landing up here on the roof. Try to keep up. Did you just call me daddy?
Daddy.
Ooh. Hold on, let me take my socks off.
Hey, yo.
Now keep them on, it gets cold.
Hey, yo.
Did you just say keep them on, it gets cold in the casket?
It's 6 feet deep, baby. There's a lot of draft down there by the bugs, baby. That's the spiders, baby. Like cold, wet now. Fill the beer.
Hands that out.
Like a cold and wet like a trap. I'm a demon driver myself. And shut your ass up.
Alright, here we go. Here they come. Here they come. One down. Watch that second. He's pushing. Down. Third one's coming. Now you're going to have to give me that sniper. Oh, I got hit right in the middle. He's going to get up before me. Green and purple have to stay alive, and I need that sniper. We don't ask questions. But we need the sniper.
It's a blue by the
cap in your ass now.
Yeah.
Enemy team is tracking your position.
Of course I'm being tracked.
What the fuck? That guy can't be hit.
Coming back up to the roof.
Come on, help me.
Told you.
I still got a bounty on the top of my head.
To the left or to the right? 47 meters to the right, up.
7 right now. Oh, I landed right on top of the kid!
Enemy dropping into the AO!
Came right around the corner and went, BAM! Your ass is dead, bitch!
Enemy UAV overhead!
Ding dong.
There are 24 enemies still out there. Kill them all! You've got a loadout drop inbound.
Getting that shit.
I see whoever's going for that.
What's one down below? More shit.
Gas is inbound. Marking new safe zone.
Watch that way, watch that way.
Boy, got real quiet real quick, didn't it?
Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the sky.
Another guy landed on it. Another guy landed on the bottom here in the fucking photo.
Yeah, those guys are annoying.
I need sniper ammo.
I do too. Shit! Run, boy! Oh, fuck, I'm dead. I'm coming in. Hands.
Stay there. Don't move.
One of you.
No, you're not. Don't go that way.
I'm not out the doors. I'm not right here. Not that way either.
Not that way either.
Fuck that shit. I'm out. I'm hiding in the corner. I'm hiding.
How much is an ammo box again? 4,500?
Yeah, 4,500.
Fuck, I'm $200 short, man. Can one of you guys spare? Never mind, I just picked it up. Cover me, I'm going. Cover me.
I need an ammo box.
Alright, munitions. I'm going to be coming up to the top of the roof again.
Is it orange? Are you orange?
I am orange. I'm Agent Smith.
And I'm dead. There's another guy around the corner.
We don't ask questions.
No, we don't.
They're all dead.
Yeah, they are.
Yes, they are.
And that's why we don't ask questions.
Orange, I need ammo.
Yeah, come on me.
Shit, oh my god, there's guys on that loadie. I'm gonna go back this way.
Mm-hmm.
Collect my shit.
Disabled vehicle, chopper's going down. Couldn't reach him, he's too far.
Jesus Christ. No, really sniping the fuck out of kids, ain't you?
I am.
Safe zone relocated. Hostile dropping into the area. Watch the skies.
Are you fucking kidding me? Kid here.
Enemy mark.
Kid here. Fuck me.
Down
shit.
Down.
There's one more over there as well.
Two.
Yep. Yeah, he pulled.
Let me look.
Right here.
22. What? 22 kills?
Holy shit, agents.
Oh, I just got sniped.
Yeah, I got sniped as well.
Where the fuck is that coming from? I'm on my way.
Agent, what the fuck are you on? I'm just asking.
We going.
We gotta go, yeah.
Reloading the SMG. Hang on, takes a minute. I know. I can hear him. I'm just not going in there, staying on top. Guys, got to get up here on the roof. I'm gonna need backup.
Yeah, I'm going up here with you. Come on. There's a team down in there somewhere.
Relocating.
I don't know where, but they're down there somewhere.
They're underneath us.
No, there's a white fucking...
Watch for those drop-ins.
Directly below us?
Yeah. Once this zone moves, we gotta move right away. Yeah, we gotta go now.
Yeah. Oh, I fell down. Fuck. Back up.
Go now. So we can catch them when they come out. Get over the half wall, take cover. Yep, I got hit. Take him out. It's all up to you guys now. That's a 30 bomb for the old man. Somebody want to pick me up? Keep fire on him. Nasty, he's coming on you. Oh, I'm hit, he's weak. One shot. Right here.
One guy left.
Got him.